Hi, I'm Toby Spanier, and I work at the University of Minnesota Extension here in Willmar.
And I'm Mahmoud Yusuf, a community leader here in Willmar.
What is your idea?
My City Academy is an idea to help new Americans and members of the receiving community better understand how the City of Willmar and Candiota County government works. My City Academy was originally created in Nashville, Tennessee. Nashville actively decided that they wanted to be a welcoming city and that embraces diversity. My City Academy helps further that vision.
My City empowers new Americans to understand and participate in Willmar's and Candiota County's government. It empowers civic leadership for all. Over the course of 6 to 7 months, My City participants will meet leaders from Willmar and Candiota County government departments and tour their facilities, such as public works, the parks, law enforcement, courts, schools, public health, economic development, social services, and transportation. In doing so, they will gain a better understanding of how their government works and learn how to resolve issues and obtain information. Upon graduation, My City participants are able to help their communities understand and access government services, which will be a ripple effect of this program. My City graduates will also have an opportunity to interact with others through their participation in a leadership alumni network, both here in Willmar and across the state.
Who will benefit from this idea?
Well, beneficiaries include academy participants, leaders and managers of the city and the county government departments. In addition, community members from which the participants belong will also benefit. Since the transfer of information and knowledge is an expectation of this program, audiences include East African Latinos, Karen, and any other new American community.
How does the idea reflect the core values?
Several of the core values from the Idea Fund are part of our efforts with the My City Academy, including leadership. Participants, such as Mohammed, are selected based on their past community leadership efforts. They will also be asked to demonstrate ongoing leadership in the transfer of the knowledge that they receive to additional community members. Inclusion. The priority of this program is to make government services more inclusive and responsive to the changing demographics. Education. We believe that being educated in how government services work will empower the public to engage with the services properly and efficiently.
Unity. We are unified in our respect for diversity and our desire to live in a unified community. Trust building, giving all the opportunities to speak their truth and have a voice in the system. Storytelling, we all have unique experiences with government services. Hearing these stories will help us better understand how to improve. Cultural responsiveness, we are creating an educational curriculum and experience paying attention to culture. An assumption busting. We fully expect that assumptions will be busted as we engage in a relationship and new understanding.
Who is involved in the development of this idea?
Well, this idea actually came to the City of Willmar from a former city administrator. She sent the idea to a current city council member who shared it with me. We then called for a meeting with a few smaller representatives, the mayor and the city council representative. When we met, all those who attended agreed that this was a good idea and we should move forward. Since that time, we've had several planning meetings to make up a design team to kind of co-create the program. The design team members include 5 Somali members, including Mohammed, a Latino representative, a city council member, and me representing Extension. The implementation of this program will involve that design team along with Extension and the selected departments both within the city and the county government.
What funds are you requesting for this idea?
We're requesting $6,000 to help support the program. This would assist in transportation, materials, barrier reduction funds for participants, and food for sessions.
Are you building connections across cultures?
Well, absolutely, yes. This is the primary purpose as we build the connections across cultures while providing valuable public information and education. This has already been happening as the design team works towards creating the content and the structure of the program.
And what else should we know about this idea?
Well, you should know that a key concept of this program is to explicitly name the expectations from all parties. Government service providers have expectations on consumers. Consumers have expectations of government providers. Oftentimes, those expectations are unclear or unknown, particularly across diverse cultures. We will be helping all those involved share their expectations and recognize that there are multiple interpretations of a single event, interaction, or situation. By increasing understanding of how government works, we can collectively work to ensure that it is working properly for all. Self-efficacy leads to a healthier individual and community. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Tor.